Alrighty, so in this quick video, I will show you how to integrate DeepSeek into Microsoft Excel. So by the end of this video, you will have a new formula and I called it DS Chat, where you can now type your prompt. For example, what is the capital of Germany? Answer in one word. And when you press enter, it will take the input from Excel. We are using the DeepSeek API and you will get the response right back here in Excel. Of course, you can also do it a little bit more complicated. For example, here we have created 1-day travel itinerary for Italy and my travel preferences are food and history. Now, when you execute this, it might take a moment until you get the response back.
12 seconds later.
Alright, and there you have it. Let me make it a little bit bigger so that we can see the output. Here's our travel itinerary. Now, if you want to have the same formula in Excel, all you need to do is to go to my GitHub repository. The download link is in the description, and from here you will need two modules. The first one will be the JSON converter, which is not from me, which is from Tim Hall. But anyways, just click on download. And then you will also need the DeepSeek module, which I created. You just want to download that as well. Once you have that, you can close this workbook here. And let's start with a new fresh workbook. All right, here you want to go to the developer tab. If that is not visible for you, you can just right click on the ribbon. Select Customize the ribbon and then tick the box next to Developer. Once you have done that, open the Visual Basic Editor by clicking here. And now go back to your Downloads folder. And from here you want to grab the two modules and just drag them over to your workbook, like so. The first thing you want to do is to compile the code. You can do this by going to debug and go to compile, because most likely you will get an error message, just like I do here, and that's because we need to activate the Microsoft scripting runtime. You can do that by going to Tools, References, and then search for Microsoft scripting runtime. Tick the box next to it and then click OK. And now when you go back to debug, compile, you shouldn't see any error messages. All right. The last thing we need to do is to get our API key from DeepSeek. You can go to platform.deepseek.com and I have it already open. Now, currently it seems they have some issues with the platform because typically what you want to do first is go to usage and to top up your account, because you do need some money in order to use the API, but currently this is deactivated. However, in my case, I've done that already last week, so I still have like $2 left in my account. So with that, you can go to API keys, create a new API key. I call it test2. And of course, I will delete this key before uploading the video. Just copy it to your clipboard, go back to Excel, paste it right in here. And now when you try it out, you will have DS Chat. Tell me a joke. Press enter. And now, as before, might take a moment. All right. And here you have it. Your own DeepSeek formula. Now, the only issue is that this formula is currently only available in my workbook. If you want to have the formula available in all your spreadsheets, we need to do it a little bit differently. So for that, let me actually start from scratch again. So let me close this one here and just open a new spreadsheet again. Now, this time what we want to do, we want to go to Developer and click on Record Macro. Now here you want to select Personal Macro Workbook. So by default, this might be this workbook, but you want to select Personal Macro Workbook. Click on OK, and then you can stop already the recording and then go to the Visual Basic Editor again. Now with that, we now have a new workbook. It's called personal.xlsb. So open it up and under the modules, you will find module 1, which is the recording we just have done. Obviously, there's nothing in there, but that doesn't matter. All we need to do Let's go back to our downloads folder, grab the two modules and paste them in here. Now also once again here, just make sure to debug, compile, click on OK, go to Tools, References, activate the Microsoft Scripting Runtime, click on OK, and now it should work. And the last thing is just to enter your API key. I still have it in my clipboard, so I can just save it here. Close the workbook, and now here's the important part. When you close the workbook here, it will ask you if you want to save the changes to your personal workbook. So here you want to click on Save. And now we will have the formula available in all our spreadsheets. And we can also test it out by just opening another spreadsheet. Now here, if you just look for the formula, you won't find it because what you need to do is to type in personal.xlsb exclamation mark, and then you can use ds chat. And then for example, here also say, tell me a joke about Excel. Oopsie. Should be closing.
One eternity later.
All right, and there you have it. Now, currently we have hard-coded our API key, but if you want to have a little bit more flexibility, you can also pick any cell here. And then once you select it, go to this name box here and type in DS API key and press enter. And now it will take the API key from this cell. So to test it out, I will just type in some random string here. So we should get an error. So let me try to execute this again. And as you can see, we get an API error. However, if I paste in my API key here and refresh the formula again, it should now work again. All right, cool. And here we have it. Now, if you go back to the module, you will also see, if you want, you can also give the optional parameters like the model, the temperature, the tokens, and so on and so forth. You can also specify it directly in the Excel formula. So if you scroll down, I've got a little example here. So this is the simple usage where we just entered the prompt. But if you want, you can also use it with the parameters. So you just separate them by a comma and then pass in the different parameters. Yeah, but anyways, this is how you can integrate DeepSeek into Microsoft Excel. Now let me point out that this will only work on Windows and it will only work on the Excel version for desktop. So on web, it won't work because we are using VBA. As I said, all the links are in the description box. I hope you found it useful. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video. Cheers!